I think everybody probably knows each and every one of these musicians that's going to be up here tonight. They're all great in their own, and each one of them plays in so many different renditions of different types of music. But when they get together here and do this, it's pretty special. So put your hands together for the New Missouri Fox Hunters.
Hello, good people. We made a set list. And all. Yeah. All right.
Super bones.
I guess I would thank you for coming instead of watching the Super Bowl, but if you're coming here, you were never going to go to watch the Super Bowl anyway, so you're welcome. Okay. Fox hunters. We don't actually hunt foxes, but we do hunt tunes.
I haven't heard that slogan yet.
Yeah, I thought of it today.
Oh, good.
I'm glad I remembered it. Okay, we're going to do a fiddle tune called Dubuque. Alena, this one's going to feature Alena as much as any fiddle tune features the fiddler.
Thank you.
This next one's a song that Mr. Ryan here wrote. He wrote a long time, way before this band came to fruition. And the band came to fruition on this stage, actually. Anyways, this is called The Worst Person in the World.
Yeah. I think I wrote this song before any of the bands I'm in now existed.
Wow.
Old.
Good? Good enough. All
right. One, two, three, two, two. I'm the worst, I'm the worst. First city in the world, I'm the worst.
Her husband's out of town and there's a car.
steps behind the stranger. From there to my house, his car stayed inside. But it wasn't till he turned into my drive that I learned I was witnessing the cold hard facts of life. I drove around the block till I was dizzy. Each time the noise came louder from within. And then I saw our bottle there beside me. I drank a fifth of courage and walked in. Oh my, you should have seen their frantic faces. They screamed and cried, please put away that knife. Well, I guess I'll go to hell, or I'll rot here in this cell. But who taught who the cold hard facts of life? Thank you so much.
Pure evil.
All right. I know. My favorite part about that story is like, you're on the side of the killer for a minute. But then you're like, but did you win? Because now you're in jail. When in search for banter. All right. It's another Fox Hunters original. This is one I wrote once I finished this banjo. Now I weep and mourn when November's here. These cold, cold winds have killed my deer. And I shouldn't have left, but I couldn't stay. Man, the shovel sure didn't get his way. So I found God to soothe my soul. But where was God when the cold wind blew? And I don't know what I should have done. Nah, but here I am with no one. Song that Alena wrote. It's a tune, rather. We call it Three Stags. Ryan does.
Where did it go?
There it is.
On the banjo.
You can think of like three deer in the woods or three golden cans on a table. Or three camo cans, depending on what time of the year it is. This one's in the key of F. Is there only one in the key of F?
Yeah.
I'm fine with that.
All right. How's it going over there?
Close.
Ryan's wearing a shirt I gave him.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It wasn't because you didn't have any clothes.
I know, I still need more.
Actually, I found this shirt. I'm wearing one too. Like 10 years ago, and I liked it so much that I bought like 6 of them. In various sizes. Just like predicting. I still have some. That's one of them. Ready?
Close enough.
Great. Three Stags. Thank you. set list, we recognized that there was no way to like write it where someone wasn't going to have to switch an instrument. So we just threw caution to the wind.
Accepted that.
And just accepted it. And now we're switching all the time.
We used to have a bigger gear problem than we have now.
Yeah.
You had to start another band to get over that.
All right. I'm already in tune.
Wow. That's what you think.
George back. This song does not reflect how I feel. I didn't call my grandfather on my mom's side grandpa. I called him Papa Boat because he had a pontoon boat. And so this song is a song I wrote about him. I was just reflecting the other day, thinking about him, and I remembered, what was I doing? Oh, I was setting up, I have a Craftsman toolbox with the sliding drawers, you know, the red and everything like that. And I was trying to think of like the first place I saw that. And it was definitely his garage. And he lived in Clinton, Missouri. And I remember, so he lived in a ranch house, and then his garage with his shop and his boat and everything was out back. And first thing I would do when we would get there is I would go to see if the garage door was open. And if it was open, then I would sneak around to see if by chance he had left one of the drawers of the tool chests open to see, just because I wanted to see tools. I wasn't going to open them. I just wanted to see what tools he had. Anyways, it's called Papa Boat. Papa Boat, where you going? Papa Boat, where you been? I think about you now, and I think about you then. And it's bacon on the stovetop and ice cream in the bin. Papa Boat, where you going? Papa Boat, where you been? And all that boat, where you going? Pop a boat, where you been? I think about you now, and I think about you then. And it's bacon on the stovetop, and ice cream in the bin. Pop a boat, where you going? Pop a boat, where you been? And the hunt might have been with a gun in your hand, or a number at an auction where all day you would stand. There was something about the kill or the winning of a bid, where even as a grandpa you still felt like a kid. And garages and kitchens is where memories are made, where lessons are learned and fights are delayed. And there's too much to do with a family to grow. I'm not sure how you done it or that you even know. Pop a boat, where you going? Pop a boat, where you been? I think about you now, and I think about you then. And it's bacon on the stovetop and ice cream in the bin. And it's Easter at the cabin each and every spring. A man, a few words, but you still said everything. And I wish I knew you now like I thought I knew you then. But I'm sure that my grandkids will have ice cream in the bin. Pop a boat, where you going? Pop a boat, where you been? I think about you now, and I think about you then. And it's bacon on the stovetop and ice cream in the bin. Pop a boat, where you going? Pop a boat, where you been? Words, we'll do a fiddle tune.
Which one?
Roaring River. Mm.
That's enough.
Yeah. Has anyone been to Roaring River State Park?
Yes.
Yes? Is it nice?
Nobody knows.
I was antiquing once and I found a Roaring River State Park patch that I gave to Alena because Alena taught us this song. Is it on anything?
Nope.
Alright. You know the folk point will be 50 years old next year? I didn't make it up. We could have brought a second banjo.
We did.
Oh.
And a third.
They're in other tunings. Okay. Roaring River State Park. It's not called Roaring River State Park. It's just Roaring River.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Thank you.
only story I have for this song is I went to Webster University for a brief stint, and I lived in the dorms because I wanted the college experience. And one of the first nights there...
So far from home.
So far.
If I took back roads, it still was not very far.
And the whole floor went out clubbing one night, like early on. And I was like, that's not my vibe. And I stayed home and learned this song in my dorms alone.
I've talked about this. That's right.
Yeah. And I'm still playing this song, and they're no longer clubbing.
So, you don't know that.
I don't know that. But if I had to choose between still doing both, one or the other, I would choose still playing this song. All right.
Fans, we were very important people.
We opened for Willie Nelson in an adjacent room. Yeah. But Nessa. But yeah, that night was the first night that song really like was cooking. Willie was
not watching it.
But we sure got those VIPs warmed up.
But we didn't get tickets, so then we went home. Yeah. They didn't even keep the food out.
I know.
They were just like, yeah. We pulled behind stage and they were like, who are you? And I was like, we're with the band. They were like, you're not Willie Nelson. All right. This is a song that Ryan wrote when he got this banjo. This, mm-hmm. this song was hiding in the banjo.
It's fairly easy to find. One, two, three, four.
From the original Missouri Frog Hunters.
Yes.
This is called Down by Missouri River.
The old Missouri Frog Hunters.
So we don't so the original Missouri Frog Hunters have actually contacted us a little bit through
One of their relatives.
One of their relatives was like, oh cool. You know, you guys are doing this thing. But they were a Missouri band and then they moved to Ohio.
Ohio. I think Ashtabula.
And they had a radio show in the 40s.
Yeah.
And they remained the new Missouri Fox Hunters. Mm-hmm. But we've tracked down songbooks of theirs that they were published and with their
records.
Songs. One of them is like their songs, and the other is like new Missouri Fox Hunters, a bunch of Carter family songs. but anyways, this is Down by Missouri River. Mm-hmm. This is an E, right? This thing?
Yes, yes.
I'm like, but this is a G. Okay.
With the turnaround.
To the C.
Yes.
Okay.
One, two, three, two.
Sycamore.
fiddling over the hills and the trees, where Missouri moon is climbing, that's where I long to be.
Thank you so much. We're going to take just a brief break, and then we'll be back.
I think if you put your hands together, we can get the three of them back out here.
Two can't hear each other. So we're going to solve it acoustically with not a flying V, but I wish.
If we start solving problems with flying Vs, I'm out.
I was thinking like Mighty Ducks flying V.
Yeah.
Oh. That's what I was thinking.
What were you thinking of?
I was thinking of that guitar, you know.
Oh.
Well, I mean, I got appreciation for Gibson. Just, you know, electronics.
All right, we're going to start with a song that Ryan wrote for this band called Fox in the Briar.
I remember how it...
This is actually about hunting foxes.
Yeah.
John, did I move the things okay?
Yeah, you moved them really good. Thank you.
Have you done this before?
Yeah.
If only Landers was here.
Yeah. Yeah, wait.
Okay. He would have been kicked out. <It's okay. laughs> All right, good?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, two, two.
Oh my gosh.
There's a fox in the briar, a fox in the briar, wild boar on the edge. Thank you.
next song is so the leader of the new Missouri, of the original Missouri Fox Hunters, was a fella named Marty Licklitter, and he went and did some solo stuff. This is one of his solo songs called Cold Hands, Warm Heart. Actually have some exciting news I'm going to share. So I don't know how many years ago, maybe four years ago, we actually cut a full record.
Well, I think it's more than 4 years ago.
Do you think so?
Yeah.
Is that relevant to the story?
No.
Okay. And we kind of shelved it. I think we don't have an exact reason, but
COVID,
yeah.
There was that.
And I moved last year, and I just finally put my CDs away last week, or the other day, and found the master recordings, and I popped it in. I had a boombox that didn't work, so I threw that away, and then I put it in my computer to try to play it, and listened through, and was happy with it. So then I called Ryan, and called Lena, and we got together, and we listened to it, and we're happy with it. So we're going to get it mastered, and put it out this year. So that's very exciting.
Yeah, a record that's already done.
Wow. Yeah, I know. It's like gold. Alright, we're gonna play this song. Alena taught us this tune. Sorry, don't listen to me.
I'm not there.
I'm premature. Just skip it. Has anyone seen Dan Gellert here before? My favorite part about seeing him is he'll spend forever tuning, and then he'll set the instrument down and pick up a different one before he ever plays the tune. Makes me think of how when you learn things from people, you learn more than what you're actually learning from them. And Alena and I both learned a lot of tunes from Colin Blair. And when Colin is trying to recall a tune, he looks up and to the left. So he's got his fiddle in his hand, and like if he's looking to the right, he doesn't ever get it. But when he goes to the left, he like moves his eyes, and then all of a sudden the tune pops into place. And Alena was teaching me this song, and like I kind of had the A part, but then I wanted the B part, and Alena was like. And found it. So you learned how to find it.
From Colin.
Yeah.
So up to the left, that's the
trick. Up and to the left, okay. Is where the tunes are held. Okay. This is a song that I wish I wrote, but I love it so much I sing it.
You know, euphoria by a bit.
Yeah, a little bit. Some songs you wish you wrote and you're just mad you didn't, so you don't sing them. Decently in tune. It's not offensively out of tune, I should say. All right. People in the city call me country.
because of how I walk and talk and smile. And I don't mind them laughing in the city, but the country folk all say I'm citified. And the fighting men, they say I'm a coward, because I never push no one around. While the gentle people call me troublemaker, because I always fight to stand my ground. It's funny, I don't fit where of all the average people. Some pious people point and call me sinner, because to them I've never seen the light. While other folks look at me like a preacher, I'm just doing what I think is right. And the wealthy people think I am a hobo, lean and hungry, writing mournful songs. While the poor people think that I am a rich man, but really, I'm just trying to get along. It's funny, I don't fit where all the average people go. Has given me a number to simplify my birth and life and death. But still my woman claims I'm awful important, like the moon, the sun, the sea, the sky, and breath. It's funny, I don't fit where of all the average people. Thank you so much. Where have all the average people gone?
Norfolk Pine. I'm going to play another song that Alena wrote. A few years ago, I fell off one of my work trucks, and I did something to my wrist, and it's been reactivated. And it only hurts when I, like, try to do push-ups like that. Anyways, the guitar is hurting tonight. It's okay. I'm just trying to think about the words. This is one of the songs that Alena wrote.
Good. Comfy?
Ready?
I'm ready.
Thank you.
you tell the story again?
I guess I can.
You probably should.
You think so?
Otherwise, it's just a song that means nothing. I might be misconstrued.
Yeah, I guess so.
Okay, I was
at an old-time jam in the woods at a blues festival.
Believable.
Okay. And this instrument is in tune all night.
Sure.
Just for sure. Anyways, there was a cabin, and then the old-time jam, and then a car on the other side of the old-time jam, and on the other side of the car was, like, shrubbery in the woods. And and so the old-time jam was going on, and I was off talking to some folks, and I noticed this stroller behind the car in the woods. And I was like, huh, that's weird. And out came someone from the cabin to go buy some pizzas for the party that was happening inside. And when they got around to the other side of their car, they were like, there's no way there's a baby in this stroller. And they lift up the sheet. And all I hear from across the car is, who put the baby in the bush? And this song's called Baby in the Bush. G. Loving mother, and I'll tell you true, they might forget me when I have the flu, but they don't leave the baby in the bush. Don't leave the baby, don't leave the baby, don't leave the baby in the bush. You can leave me for another man, hit me in the head with a frying pan, throw my money in a garbage can, but don't leave the baby in the bush. Over to the other and said, what'd mama do with brother Ned? She left the baby in the bush. Oh, some folks say her breath is sweet, but I'd much rather smell her feet. She sounds like a hog when she goes to eat, but she don't leave the baby in the bush. Now she don't leave the baby, now she don't leave the baby in the bush. Car. I didn't go to move the car too far. I looked in the bush, said, there you are. I found the baby in the bush. I found the baby, I found the baby. Thank you, Jeff Herman and John Baldwin, for running all the electronical part of this acoustic show. And for the ladies in the back taking the tickets, thank you so much. Road in Black Cat County,
not knowing that the sheriff had paid a bounty for men like me that haven't got a penny to their name. And he locked my legs to 35 pounds of blackjack county chain. And all we had to eat was bread and water. And every day we had to build that road a mile and a quarter. And a black snake whip would cut our backs if some poor fool complained. And you couldn't fight back wearing 35 pounds of blackjack county chain. And one night while the sheriff lay sleeping, we all gathered around him, slowly creeping. And heaven help me to forget that night in the cool, cool rain, when we beat him to death with 35 pounds of blackjack county chain. Now the whip marks have all healed, and I am thankful that there's nothing but the scars around my goal. But most of all, I'm glad no man will be a slave again to a black snake whip and 35 pounds of blackjack county chain. To a black snake whip and 35 pounds of blackjack county chain.
Alright, we can do Salt's Kisses or Can You Hear? We have a choice to make here.
I know.
Oh, you man. Choose. You guys are no help. Okay.
Yeah, I think it is your choice.
I think after that, we do Salt's Kisses.
Okay.
Okay? Because Can You Hear is like...
Kind of like that.
Kind of like that. Okay, artistic decision made. A song that I wrote called Salty Kisses. As I think about all the love we've had, I find myself forgetting the bad. And if that ain't love, then I don't know what is. 'Cause there's nothing better than a salty kiss. Like the sprout of a seedling in the winter's last sun. The start may be rocky, but I know you're the one. And I do not fear
swimming and the starving that I'm all about. You're the strings on my banjo that I don't wanna change. That's just one thing that you shouldn't rearrange. And as I pick this last melody, at the end of the night, it's just you and me. These dusty old floors that we just can't keep clean, I can always count on your horizon beams. At the end of the night, it's just you and me. And someday I sure hope that people will say that you look like each other, and how'd you get that way? 'Cause then we'll have no more love to share. Because when you're one, the start ends right there. And I'd like to ask at the end of our days, if you'd be with me in just one final way, with the granite above as we rest our weary bones. Even with no souls, we won't be alone. Thanks so much. We added this song to the set because it's called the Tennessee Mountain Fox Chase. And we're the Missouri Fox Hunters. Thank you.
same thing.
Oh, look at you. I don't. Tennessee Mountain Fox Chase.
Good tune, Alena. What tuning is this in? You don't know. Oh, okay.
It's the A. Your high string.
Yeah.
All right.
Battle. In 2017, I had like an unexplained explosion of hives across my entire body for like 3 months. And they couldn't really figure out what was going on. But you know how it happens when you're trying to figure out what's going on. You're on all kinds of things. So I was on like 80 milligrams of prednisone and doxepin and all this stuff for weeks. And ended up being a low vitamin D. But while I was on all those antihistamines and steroids, I wrote this song. It was wild. I was like not showering, you know, and oh man, I was so gross.
I forgot about that till now.
Yeah. Yeah, people were calling like, what happened to you? I'm like, I don't know. I'm wearing the wrong picks. Dang it. This song is not about that either. So I'm not going to sing about prednisone and doxepin and hives. What's that? Yeah. It was 1 milligram and 2 milligrams. So they wean you off, you know? Oh, man, I did not follow doctor's orders towards the end. I was so done with it. You're supposed to, like, wean off prednisone. And I went, like, 80, 40, done. Anyways, okay. This is called The Battle of the Lord and the Devil. It's not about that. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you.
Super Bowl. Thank you so much for coming out on a Sunday night. This is the one and only Alena Wheeler. The very friendly Ryan Koenig. My name's Nick Pence.
Yeah.
And we are the new Missouri Fox Hunters. Hunters not of animals, but of songs, tunes, and tales.
We made a record years ago.
Yeah.
It'll be out sometime this year.
All right.
Get that record, we need us.
That's right.
Yes. Yeah.
Me and Lem Briggs and old Bill Brown taking a load of corn to town. My old Jim Dog, the darned old cuss, he just naturally followed us. We drove past that country store and the boys came running on out the door. Jim, he hid behind the box while all them fellas were throwing rocks. Every time I go to town, the boys started kicking my dog around. Makes no difference if he is a hound, you gotta quit kicking my dog around. Hold a grudge. Once when I ate too much fudge, they took a rope and they tied me up, but they didn't count on old Jim Pup. Nah, Jim saw his duty there and then, and he tore into those gentlemen. He sure messed up that courthouse square with wrecks and meat and hiding hair. And the sheriff came to stop the fuss, and all them boys shook hands with us. We gathered around that load of corn, and every boy had a healthy horn. Every time I go to town, the boys gonna kick my dog around. It makes no difference if he is a hound, you gotta quit kicking my dog around. To his tail, ran around the county jail. That made us a dead burn sore. So Lem he cussed and Bill he swore. So me and Lem Briggs and old Bill Brown, we lost no time and we got him down. Caught them fellers on the ground for kicking my old Jim dog around. Every time I go to town, the boys gonna kick my dog around. Makes no difference if he is a hound, you gotta quit kicking my dog around. The dog ain't worth no cash, but I can tell you that he ain't no trash. Wakes me up before the break of day, and he keeps some revenue boys away. He's the best old dog that you ever did see. Wherever I go, he follows me. His voice is sweet, and his name is Jim. He'd fight for me, and I'd for him. Every time I go to town, boys gonna kick my dog around. Makes no difference if he is a hound, you gotta quit kicking my dog around. Thank you all. Have a great night. Being left on a sad note.
It is folk
music.
Ah, yes.
Okay. D. This is an original. Dusty old book. Can you hear him read a blessing with a clever little hook? Can you hear your brother resting as your bride spins her best ring? Can you hear read a blessing? Can you hear? Can you hear the hearse break down on that muddy gravel road? Can you hear the hearse break down? Carries its last load. Can you hear your brother kneel down as he carries you to the burying ground? Can you hear the hearse break down? Can you hear? Can you hear the wind whistle over that deep hole in the ground? Can you hear the wind whistle? Oh, that bone-chilling sound. Your mother grabs a thistle, says nothing hurts like this will. Can you hear the wind whistle?
Thank you.